Hi, my name is Lisa Mondiello, and I am a registered nurse at Hospital for Special Surgery, and I take care of patients after they have had orthopedic surgery. Osteoarthritis is one of the most common forms of joint disease in the world. I see firsthand the pain this disease can inflict on patients. According to the Centers for Disease Control, osteoarthritis, commonly known as OA, affects over 30 million American adults. It causes pain and stiffness in the weight-bearing joints. This means hips, knees, spine, hands, or parts of the feet. If you have osteoarthritis, you will feel an achy pain in your joints. Usually the pain will stay just around the joints and only on one side of your body. There are many causes of osteoarthritis. At first, pain stems from inflammation in the fluid around the joints. Later, pain can occur when cartilage wears out. Cartilage is the smooth substance at the end of bones that cushions the joints. When it wears out, the bone is exposed. You may have heard the expression bone on bone. This is what that phrase is referring to. If you have joint pain at night or while at rest, in other words, when you are not moving around much, then you likely have a more severe case of osteoarthritis. Most people experience early morning stiffness or stiffness after not moving around for a while. The pain usually subsides after moving around. You might feel as if your knees buckle under you when you go downstairs or step down from a curb. At times, the joint can be warm, which can indicate inflammation of the joint.
Hi, my name is Rachel Luscombe, and I'm a registered nurse at Hospital for Special Surgery. I take care of patients after they've had orthopedic surgeries. Since the main symptom of osteoarthritis is pain, I'm going to discuss some methods to treat the pain that this disease may be causing. The treatment that is right for you will depend on how severe your pain is and what methods work best for your body. First, let's talk about treatments that you can try that don't involve medications. Icing the affected area reduces pain in two ways. It reduces the swelling that causes pain in the first place, and it numbs the painful area. Applying heat is a comfort measure that can relax the muscles that may be in a painful spasm. The goal of any treatment is to decrease pain and inflammation so that you can continue to do what you like to do. Positioning your body to ensure the painful area is well supported can also be helpful in reducing pain. Orthotics, splints, canes, and walkers may also be used to improve mobility with decreased pain. If these interventions don't treat your pain effectively, then your healthcare provider may suggest some medications. Acetaminophen is commonly used to treat pain. It can be taken with or without food, and it's very safe and effective when taken at appropriate doses. Acetaminophen has the potential for liver damage, so if you have any problems with your liver, be sure to talk to your healthcare provider before taking it regularly. Many other medications contain acetaminophen, especially cold medications. Read all labels carefully to see if anything you are taking contains it. If so, adjust your dose to stay within a safe range and avoid overdose. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, sometimes called NSAIDs for short, include ibuprofen and naproxen, which you can purchase over the counter. There are also others that your doctor may prescribe. These medications are very effective in decreasing inflammation that causes pain. Unlike acetaminophen, NSAIDs should always be taken with food because they can be rough on your stomach and can even cause ulcers. They can also increase your blood pressure and have been linked to heart attack and stroke, so be sure to take the lowest dose for the shortest period possible. If you have kidney problems, be sure to let your healthcare provider know because they can be hard on your kidneys. Aspirin is less commonly used for pain, but it can be effective. In some cases, your care provider may prescribe stronger pain medication, known as opioids or narcotics, to help with short-term relief. These medications should only be used as a last resort because they can lead to dependency, addiction, and even overdose. Side effects include nausea, vomiting, and constipation.
There are creams you can apply yourself over the affected area. These may include numbing agents or NSAIDs. Some examples are capsaicin and methyl salicylate. Your doctor may also prescribe an injection directly into the joint or the spine. Some decrease inflammation and pain, and others cushion and lubricate the joint. Your doctor can help you decide what medication works best for you. Another option for pain relief is a transcutaneous electric nerve stimulation or TENS machine. A TENS machine is thought to disrupt the pain cycle by delivering a non-painful sensation to the skin around the pain site. These treatments, when used in conjunction with physical therapy to strengthen the muscles around the joint, may allow you to avoid surgery completely or put it off for years. But if none of these interventions are successful for you, surgery may be considered. There are a variety of types of surgeries depending on the joint, the severity of your osteoarthritis, your health, and more. Thank you for listening. but most importantly, see your healthcare provider to ensure the best possible outcome and to develop a treatment plan that works for you.